Hey guys, and welcome back to Skyrim Season 2. So here we've just got Rowan looking beautiful as ever. And is that some sort of fish jumping in the waterfall? It is too! Oh wow, that's so cute. So we're going to be starting the Forgotten City mod this ep. If I can just find a courier to give me a note. Apparently that's how you start the mod. A courier gives you a note about the Forgotten City or something along those lines. So I'm just going to go to Riverwood, which is the nearest city to where I was practicing my magic. Gosh, those pauldrons make it look like her shoulders are up around her ears. Oh dear. Courier, come at me, bruh. Courier? No? Yes? No? Is this considered a town? Surely this counts. Still no courier. No, here he is. This is a courier, right?
I've been looking.
Strange
for
gloves.
Got something I'm supposed to do.
Yay! Thank you.
Let's see.
Oh gosh, I'm the brain getting wet. Looks not like ideal.
Got to go.
Thank you. Okay.
Beyond imagining.
What the?
I found these words inscribed in ancient dwarven ruins in the Reach.
It speaks.
I believe they mark the entrance to a forgotten city. My brother went in a few days ago and hasn't returned.
Your voice is so faint, I can barely hear you.
I need someone I can count on to go in after him and bring him back alive. I've heard great things about you, which is why
what
I'm
the
asking for your help.
You've
I'll
heard things about me.
The ruins. Please hurry. And remember, riches beyond imagining.
I've already got Cassia. Riches beyond imagining, Cassia. Okay. Apparently this woman knows us. Okay. Started the Forgotten City. Actually, let's just go to the journal first. Forgotten City. Let's get rid of that. A woman named Cassia has written to me, asking for my help in some hidden dwarven ruins. I should travel to the Reach to investigate. Meet Cassia and the Forgotten Ruins. Where are they? BT dubs. Great! It's a Dwemer ruin. I know she just said that, but I kind of tuned out. It's a Okay, what's the best way to get there? Probably from here. I can't see. It's absolutely foggy in that part of the map at the moment. Let's try from Reachcliff. And we somehow want to go uphill, I believe. Holy fuck me. But I haven't practiced my magic! Oh god, flying bear. Go away! No one asked for you to be here. Gosh, dramatic much? Oh my god, is something else attacking me? How do you miss? Well, you know it's not attacking me yet, but yeah. As soon as it has killed the fox, it'll come after me. I don't have enough magicka. Well, that's depressing. Go away, bear. Nobody asked for your opinion. I am loving that magic, though. The natural magic. Go, druid! Oh. Is it down? I'm so lost. Where is it? Or is it up? Up somewhere. I don't actually know. Where is this darn thing? Is it in the river? Oh, for Christ's sake. Is this the entrance? It looks like it could be. Oh, that is so rad. That's awesome. You go under the waterfall to get to the Dwemer Ruins. This is so cool. I love it when things are hidden behind waterfalls. Oh, wow. Yeah, hi, but extra water. Great. And a lucky bone. Awesome. Oh my god. Just check out the lighting and everything. How cool is that? And the token skiva. Great. Wow. Dwemer Ruins never do that. Oh, hi, are you Cassia? Hi, I'm Rowan. Apparently you heard great things about my druid prowess.
That's close enough. Who are you?
I'm Rowan. I got your letter?
Oh, it's you. I'm so glad you're here.
Look, you don't look it.
I don't know how much time we have left. My brother went down this shaft a few days ago, and I'm worried.
Why didn't you go with him?
I need you to go in after him and bring him back to me alive.
What?
It
Why
could
can't
be
you
dangerous,
go?
But if anyone can do it, it's you. Now, are you ready?
I don't get why she's sending me by myself. Why doesn't she accompany Rowan down into the Dwemer ruins? Very strange. Whoop! Sorry, I was trying to do something about the glare. Come back here, Cassia! About your request.
Look,
God, we're very
ready
close
to go
and personal.
Or not?
Wow, such attitude. You're asking me to do something that's likely going to get me killed for no return. I have some questions.
All right, but please hurry.
Your brother's been down here for days. A little longer to answer my questions is not going to take much longer. So who are you?
My name's Cassia.
I got that much,
my
thank you.
My brother and I came to Skyrim from Cyrodiil with the Imperial Legion.
Oh yeah, you're totally dressed up as one of the Legionnaires.
A break to explore.
Is that allowed?
Routes.
So you're both deserters?
We didn't want to get involved in this stupid war in the first place.
We
came here because we were conscripted.
Neither did I.
But our unit was wiped out by Nords and those forsworn savages.
Oh no.
We saw a chance to get away from the fighting altogether.
That's
so
terrible.
We took it.
So you're chilling illegally in Skyrim. So what happened here exactly?
Well, we came here hoping to find something valuable to pay for carriage back to Cyrodiil.
Oh.
Altrius went down the shaft, but he asked me to stay here.
So why haven't you gone down there yourself?
Because he made me promise I'd stay here and wait for him no matter what. And I keep my promises. Well, except as far as the Legion is concerned.
You can't just pick and choose when you keep your promises and claim you keep your promises. It doesn't really work that way, honey. And why did you send for me, of all people? Ah,
so
fuck.
So you ready to go now?
Apparently. Give me the other question.
All right, but please hurry.
Why did you send for me, of all people?
I was in Markarth looking for help when I heard people talking about you
about
and all
Rowan.
The loot you've been trading with merchants all over Skyrim. I figured you'd be interested in exploring these ruins, so I asked a courier to track you down.
Wow,
and
these couriers actually are pretty skilled. Okay, that's all the questions then.
So you're ready to go now?
I'm ready.
All right.
What?
Please,
oh my god, I hate my PC. That's all the
so
freaking
you're ready
questions.
To go now?
I am ready!
I knew I could count on you. Now quickly, go!
I'm sorry, love. But why does that have a full stop after Forgotten City? Missions don't have full stops. Ugh, that's gonna irk me. And don't tell me what to do, Cassia. I will do it when I'm perfectly ready to do it. I take orders from no one. Oh gosh, darn, it's on a tongue I'm doing it. Ah, fuck me. But the book! The book is up there! God damn it. I was just trying to read. Now if I missed some key facts. Oh well, Rowan will survive. She's a trooper. Well, technically I could unlock that, but F it. Oh, someone's already broken into that one. Hi, are you Altrius? You can't be. There's no way you could be that decimated. Is that water? No? Oh no, it's just steam. I thought it was water. It's very hazy and very unsafe. Should you be inhaling that, Rowan? I don't think it's very safe. Okay. Into the Forgotten City. Altrius, oh Altrius. Your sister sent for you. Nice. Oh, it's another one of those things. Does the dragon appear when you shout at it too? Should I be investigating? Or just going directly ahead? Oops, this button. What's this do? Okay. Let's just keep to the main path then. At least I know what it is now. I can investigate at will. Oh my god! Did someone hang themselves? Is it Altrius? Hi, old man. I don't really need your stuff, so you can keep that. You can be clothed in death. You can't be Altruis. I mean, you're wearing Imperial stuff, but you're too old. Unless her brother is significantly older than her. Quill... suicide note.
To whoever reads this...
Can't believe it's got voiceovers!
I am so sorry you had to find me like this.
Yeah, no, how rude.
And worse, that you will share my fate.
Excuse me? I'm not hanging myself.
I have spent a lifetime in this place. Going around and around in circles, searching for a way out.
Oh, you couldn't find a way out.
But there are only two choices.
Wait,
death,
what?
Or the door to the house on the lake.
Time passes differently.
I made the mistake of opening that door. I thought I could help them if I found the right one, but whatever I did, it took me right back to that lake house. In the end, all I learned is that some things are worse than death. I urge you to learn from my mistakes. Best to take your own life now and find out what awaits you beyond that door.
Charming.
I've locked it and hidden the key.
You suck.
I'll guard it with my eternal soul if I have to. But I fear even that will not be enough. For the lake house calls to you. And when it does, you must not listen. Altruis.
You do realize, Altruis, that telling me no only intrigues me more? What is at the lake house? If you told me what was at the lake house and why I shouldn't go to the lake house, then I wouldn't be intrigued or curious. But because you haven't told me, now I need to know. But, oh my god, so that means that time passes differently down here, or at least it passes differently in the lake house. That Altruis has become an old man and spent, as you said, a lifetime down here. Retrieve the lake house key from Altruis's ghost on the Citadel balcony. Jesus Christ, okay, well, let's back up this way. What was the first goal? Explore for the way out or optional. Oh, it was optional to do these things? Gosh. Okay. Let's head to the Citadel, guys. We are apparently looking for Altruis's ghost. Can you tell me why I shouldn't go to the lake house, Altruis? Wait, why would this ghost give me the key? Why is this ghost even here? So many questions. So few answers. I.e. none.
I was what? In your shoes once.
Hi, Altruis.
A lifetime ago. I remember the way the lake house calls to you.
Hi? Is there even anything here? Nope, I can just sleep here. I don't really want to, but... Skooma. I don't know that I need some skooma, but thank you for offering. Is there anything valuable down here? Like a golden quill? Is that a book? Songs of Skyrim Revised. Okay, well, sure. Why not? Doesn't hurt, right? Oh, we're going the right way. Oh. Oh, we may as well. How nice of it to light itself accordingly.
I thought to myself, do I want to die in here alone? Or do I want to open that door?
Well, you obviously chose to open the door.
Oh
my god. Someone else was down here.
And yet, in the end,
is that a dream of Southern God?
Death.
An explorer's guide to Skyrim. Map updated. That's pretty cool. I will take it. I don't know what it's added to my map. What did it add to my map? Obviously it's not going to tell me what it's added to my map. Okay. Well, that's a really useful map. Anywho. I don't think I really need... Nah, don't really need those. This is quite maze-like. Holy crap. I hope I don't have to fight you. I'm by myself. And I'm pretty damn weak, let it be said. Okay, not the balcony. It's just another room. Okay. And there's... Oh, there's something else there. Oh, let's just go this way. Oh, there's another door. God, there's stuff everywhere. My god, it even goes higher. Ah! Where do you even lead? Oh, you're just side chamber. Okay. Let's go up again, I think. Yes, it's still lighting my path. This must be correct. Unless it just lights my path anyway.
Understand.
Ah, fuck me.
The lake house door.
Take that, Skiva!
It
was a bit overkill. Well, I'm sorry, but you really piqued my curiosity, and it may be a mistake to you, but it might be. Oh, hi!
You ignore my words.
Don't attack me.
That's
Arya. I knew she was gonna come. Don't avoid my tempest or torrent or whatever the hell it is I'm using. Did that kill you? Did that kill you? Where's your body? Where's the key? I'm sorry, I didn't really want to kill your soul, but you attacked me first. Is the key out here? Somewhere? Key, oh fair key. Here you are. Lake house? Where's the lake house? Holy shit. That is so ill-advised.
Lake house.
Oh my god, check out the health search. Why can't I heal? Oh, because it heals me automatically. Wait, what? You've got healing on both hands, right? Oh, is that how fast healing works? I've never used it before, so I don't really know. Anywho, now that I've completely and utterly just plummeted three floors, although they're technically higher than three floors, where is the lake house? Oh, is that the lake house? Doesn't look so terrible now, does it, Altrius? Gosh, just check out the lighting here, it's so stark. Oh, wow! You can really see that the Dwemer lived here. The little stalls and the little shops that I can't access, but that's okay. I'm not gonna hold it against you. Okay, well, there's nothing else to do. I'm more than happy to just continue on to the lake house. What's around here? Gosh, there's so much to the city. I mean, come on, there's a big tower. Can I go to the big tower? It's a pretty little lake. Oops, I'm terribly sorry. I didn't mean to run into your corpse. How did you die, if you don't mind me asking? It's a very strange position to die in. Oh, it's a boat. Don't know why you need a boat, but there's a boat. In fact, wait, is there a lake in a lake house? It's a good question. It looks like there's another pathway that way if I ever come back here. Okay, looks like we're going to the lake house, where I've been told I should not go. Okay. The hell? Oh, because it's like a portal. Strange door. I'm going to assume it doesn't take me back out when I ask it nicely. What else do we have here? Another note. Metellus's... No? Is that how you say his
Seven
name?
7 years ago, I discovered this wondrous city, uninhabited. Others soon followed, heeding my invitation, and our community grew and prospered under my rule.
Oh, is that your stuff out back?
I am alone once again, for my subjects have been the victims of an unspeakable atrocity.
Oh no.
This is why, at the expense of my own life, I must open a portal that will take you into the past.
What?
Before all this began. Beloved reader, you must go back, investigate what set this atrocity in motion, and prevent it by any means necessary.
Why, he's a Jarl? A Jarl of where? Exactly. Marcus? It's the closest city. Strange. But if you wanted me to go to the pass, stop what killed all your people, doesn't that then change my history and my past and how Skyrim has been affected in the years since? I don't know, I don't like that idea. Just gonna steal all your fragments because that's the kind of person I am. Oh, there's literally nothing here. Do I just go back to the strange door and it will take me... No. Take me to your past? Oh my god, is that you? I'm terribly sorry. Yeah. Good luck, Rowan. Good luck. Have fun in the past. That means there'll be people here. There'll be people. Oh my god, this is what it looked like in its heyday? It looks just like Markarth. Actually, the same kind of structures. Forget me not. Find a way back to your original timeline. Wow. These objectives are so unbelievably vague. Okay. Well, wow. I'm assuming there's so much to discover now. I'm curious about what's over there. This is a very large map. A very, very large map. Oh, look at all these people. Firefly Finery. Oh my gosh. The Citadel. Wow. There's so much to see and do here. I'm still curious about this pathway. So much to do. Okay. Can I harvest imp stools? I don't know why I'd want to. Yeah, bruh, what's up? Dooley.
We're not supposed to talk to new people till they see the Jarl.
Oh, I'll be meeting the Jarl who I just read the letter from, whose name I can't pronounce. Okay, what's your story?
My what? My story? Oh, do you want to hear about me?
I asked.
I'm sorry, but my memory's not very good. I only remember... Yeah,
Dooley, you don't sound like you're all there.
I came here with my brother, Haribon. He used to look after me, and he said he always would, but then he died. Now, nobody looks after me. I'm not very good at remembering things. Sometimes I forget, so I need help. That's why I need some help finding Haribon's treasure.
What are you looking for?
Oh, Haribon said I should only tell someone I trust. Only someone I know. Not you. I don't know you yet. Do I?
Oh dear. His memory is really shoddy.
Not yet.
Do you know a way out? There's really no point in asking him.
A way out? Oh, no. I can't leave. I need to find Haribon's treasure first.
Okay, well, I'll be going now.
Oh. All right.
Oh, it's so sad. I think he's got a few issues. Is there anything else back here? I'm assuming that's where you sleep. Anything else? Nope. That looks like it for this little part of the world, which is fine. You know, I don't really know what to expect. Oh, I'm terribly sorry.
Hello
to you too. I'm sorry. I just totally rammed into you. Oh, thank God I made it. I'm not exactly the most navigationally friendly person. Wow, this place is awesome. So you guys built this inside the Dwemer ruins?
Hilda,
hey, Gulliver.
Where did you come from?
Well, now that you mention it, there was this funky door over at the lake house. I've just arrived, Gulliver.
Strange. It looks like you just came out of the Jarl's private lake house.
Oh dear. I got lost. I did. There was a time portal in there, which brought me here from the future. Then again, this is Rowan, and I don't think she would lie.
A what? Oh, I see. You're a little bit crazy.
Apparently.
Well, you're in good company here, my friend. Lots of us weren't thinking straight when we arrived.
Seriously, what is today's date?
It's the first day of last year.
Shit, what day was the journal written? I don't remember. What year?
I guess you hit your head pretty hard coming down the shaft, huh? It's the 194th year of
the
fourth era.
That's the same year
that
the atrocity happened, right?
You seem a little... you know.
Just say it, Gulliver.
So I'll make this nice and simple for you. Live by our laws
and we will all get along just fine.
Your laws, what do they entail?
Don't hurt anyone, don't steal anything. Same as anywhere else.
Well, actually.
Only the punishment.
There's a thing called the Thieves Guild and the Dark Brotherhood.
Much worse. The Jarl can tell you more and help you get settled in.
You speak so slowly.
Might even have some quarters for
you. Why can't people speak faster?
I can take you to him if you like.
I'll make my own way, thank you.
Suit yourself. I'll find him at the top of the citadel. He's got the whole floor to himself. And his daughter.
Oh, so his daughter would have died as well.
If you have any questions about this place, I'd talk to Brawl the Scholar.
Okay.
Seems to know a lot.
Sure.
About a lot of things.
Do it on the way to the citadel.
See you around.
Thank you, Gulver. It's incredibly helpful to a crazy person like poor Rowan. Oh, tree stump. Okay. Oh, look at the tree. It's in bloom. Oh, so beautiful. Anybody home? Ysmar. I've come to ask crazy questions that you can't answer. Except no one's in here, which makes it very awkward that I'm in here. Maybe we shouldn't be going into people's houses. Let's just find Zim Brawl the Scholar. Oh, there's shoes outside. Oh, this is Gulfer's house. Yo, so pretty. What have we got here? Vernon's fresh produce. Okay. Hi, Vernon. What up?
Welcome. Now, I trust you've had your time to the yarn.
Not yet, but you're quite a striking man in this world of Skyrim, because they tend to be quite unattractive. Other than Bryn, of course. Bryn's a bit of a nice one. So what's your story?
Me? I'm Vernon, your friendly grocer and all around nice guy.
No.
You want fresh food, you're in the right place. You want...
Wait. Did you hear that?
Nope. Hear what?
Oh. Someone just slid another letter under my door.
And that's a problem because...
Do me a favor and grab that before anyone else sees it.
What? What? What's in the letter? Read anonymous note. Vernon, you are an abomination. Remember the dwarves' law. The many shall suffer for the sins of the one. You may have hidden your sins from the dwarves so far, but they're the least of your worries. Your neighbor. Wait a minute. There are dwarves? I've never seen a dwarf in Skyrim. Yo, what up with the note, Vernon? Stud muffin you?
What did it say?
Why is somebody writing you threatening notes?
Look, I haven't done anything wrong.
I never said you did.
It's not as if I'm a vampire or a necromancer or
check,
anything.
Check!
Somebody just has a problem with my preference.
Why are the good ones always gay? Oh, life sucks. You like men?
Nothing gets by you, does it? Sorry, that was me. Yes, I like men.
Which is okay. I've got nothing against it. You came from Windhelm. Cool.
I saw it's a long way to travel. Attacked and driven away by angry Nords to know the cost of not keeping your personal affairs to yourself.
It's true enough.
I hid who I was for. What was it? 20 years. Living in the barracks with a dozen other guardsmen, watching.
Oh yeah, they might not look at it favorably.
But that kind of fear eats away at you slowly, until living isn't any better than the thing you were afraid of. And that's when I came clean. Needless to say, since I'm now living underground on the opposite corner of Skyrim, my openness didn't go well among the Nords of Windhelm.
The Nords of Windhelm are very close-minded.
I get to be who I am. Or, at least, I thought that was the case. Perhaps I was wrong.
I suspect that your neighbor might in fact be gay themselves and is so afraid of these feelings that he's taking it out on you. That's what I think, Vernon. But do you know who it is?
No, I don't.
Want to do like a handwriting sample?
I keep my personal affairs to myself, and I've never really been interested in any of the men here. Not my type.
It's a bit sad.
It wouldn't usually bother me. I have a thick skin, and I can handle myself in a fight better than most.
Good on you, Vernon.
But if these threats keep getting worse, eventually my secret admirer is going to get violent and break the dwarves' laws.
Oh well, I'm sure it'll sort itself out. No, I'll look into it for you. I'll try and find this person.
Really?
Don't know how,
I didn't expect
but apparently
that.
I will.
Thanks. It's always a relief to meet someone who's so open-minded.
Rowan is a druid. She's very open and one with nature.
Start by working out who uses red ink, or...
Is it ink or blood?
Blood on their letters.
I don't, couldn't really tell. It looked like ink.
Know what you find.
Okay. Cool. I'm happy to take on that mission. Yeah, I've got to talk to everybody. Gosh darn it. Well... Dear God, I hope he's still not alive. Who have we got here? The Firefly Finery. Oh, it's such a beautiful name. Hi. Oh, this is what all your houses look like. So it's very practical. Ooh, note. Can I read the note? Reward notice. Reward. Golden ring. Belonged to our deceased son. High sentimental value. Reward available for retrieval. Harbig and Miranda. Are you Harbig? You are too, Habik. Sorry.
Newcomer.
It's a Q.
I trust you've spoken with the Jarl already.
Why does everybody say that? I haven't gotten there yet. I'll get there. Don't arrest me, just because I'm a bit slow getting there. What's your story?
I'm Habik.
Habik.
I live out back with my wife, Miranda.
You mean down below? There's no out back.
But, we had to leave. Found this place by accident.
How does someone find the Forgotten City by accident? You have to go through a waterfall to get here.
So I volunteered. Doesn't make any money, of course. Not enough customers.
I was thinking, there's not that many people down here, technically.
He likes to keep us busy and out of trouble. But of course, he and all his cronies in the Citadel.
Oh, so the Jarl's not well liked. If the Jarl is so unfair, why don't you overthrow him?
I wish it was that simple. But with the Dwarves' Law, everybody here is terrified of doing anything wrong.
I've yet to meet your dwarves.
In case it gets us all killed. The dwarves wrote, "The many shall suffer for the sins of the one." But we don't know what they meant by sin. Theft. Violence, probably.
Oh!
But maybe they meant all sorts of things, like dishonesty or disobedience to the Jarl. That's what Metellus would like to think, anyway. So I could ignore his orders. Sure. I could even lead an uprising against him. Gods know most of us are sick of him, but I'd be risking the lives of everyone here. And I just don't want to be responsible for that. So here I am, running my shop. Could be worse.
Okay, so the... many will pay for the sins of one. That's obviously the atrocity that's happened and killed everybody down here. The question is, whose atrocity was it? My money's on the Jarl's daughter. That's what I'm gonna say. Because, you know, he doesn't seem to care about his people, but his daughter seems to be the reason why he'd like to go back and save everybody. But in a cruel twist of fate, it's usually that person that's done the bad thing. I don't know. Why did you leave Solitude?
Our son.
Oh, he had a son.
He was working at my stables outside the city.
Oh, you worked at the stables?
He was alone.
How long ago is this? I don't remember what year we're in.
Imperial. A cousin of the High King. This Imperial thought he'd just take one of the horses as a
tithe. What a prick.
Guess he didn't think a 12-year-old boy was going to stop
him. What a prick.
But Lamar wouldn't stand for it.
Good on Lamar.
And as the thief rode off, my son managed to shoot an arrow
into
his shoulder.
Oh, good on him. That was only 12.
But I...
Oh no, he cut him down, did he?
I wasn't there at the time. I came back from the market to find my son's body. Trampled in the dirt.
What a prick!
It was...
I can't believe someone would even do that!
I can't begin to describe it.
That's awful!
I was shattered.
Is that why you and Miranda moved here?
I went straight to Torig's court and demanded justice. But I guess that word doesn't mean
much
to
an Imperial. I'm technically
instead,
an Imperial, because I couldn't change my race.
And told me if I ever set foot
bro, where are you going? You're just putting down the staircase.
End up the same way as Lamar.
Really?
So we left. Wandered Skyrim for a while, and and eventually wound up here. I was hoping this place would be better. I was wrong.
I'm gonna go out on a limb here and say that the person who created the Forgotten City must have been a Stormcloak supporter, I think. Because you're making Torug out to be a very bad man when he really wasn't. Then again, the gay guy, shit, Vernon, that was his name. Vernon said that Nords were close-minded, in which case that would be an Imperial supporter. But this just seems harsher against poor Torug. The guy's dead. Oh, I suppose you don't know that, do you? I'm sorry to hear that. Let's talk about something else.
All right.
Do you know a way out of here?
No, I don't.
What are you pointing for?
But I'd wager that if anyone does know a way out, it's the Jarl.
Oh, you're all stuck
but
here.
Of course, if he told anyone, he'd be ruling over an empty city.
Ah, about your missing ring. I don't have it.
Ah, you saw my notice then. What about it?
I'd like to help. An idea where I should start looking.
Thank you.
God, I'm gonna be a philanthropist helping everybody.
The ring belonged to my son, Ymar.
Oh my god, that's so sad.
He told me it was a gift from a strange wood
Wait,
elf
what?
In the forest once.
That's a little
it
creepy.
It was the only thing I had to remind me of him. But a while ago, I dropped it down the stairs in my shop.
Oh, so I have to investigate your house.
It rolled under a door at the bottom. The trouble is, I've never been able to unlock the door or work out what's down there. But I'm sure it's possible.
So there's another way in?
So I'll bet that somebody, somewhere in the city, knows a way down there. And who knows what else you'll find once you get in.
Okay. What do you have for sale?
Only the finest clothes in town.
I kinda like my armor, but I don't need weapons, I'm just curious. So he's got a whole heap of dwarven objects. Cool. But your apparel. You got some circlets. Some nice clothes. Zero value to anybody. Oh my god, that looks pretty cool. These things are really weird though. The gauntlets, they stick out a lot. Helmet of water breathing. Well, that's pretty nifty. Ooh. Ooh, I love the elven stuff. The elven. Awesome. I do quite like that one. That looks so cool. What does it look like when it's on you? I want to buy it. Oh, it's got like pathetic armor rating. Doesn't matter. You can always try it on later. I'm going to buy that. I'll always give it a go at some point. Oh, wow, you really do sell a lot of stuff at the Firefly Finery. Oh, have I tried that one? I don't do illusion spells, but just check out how cool the armor would be. It seems to be of level armor with what I'm currently wearing. Yeah, let's take it. Ooh, I had Minor Magicka. This one's Minor Destruction. I might actually change it out for that ring. God, I'm buying so much from you, bro. Yeah, okay, I think that's all I need from you, Hubbick. I probably need to sell something, but oh well.
See you again soon, I hope.
I hope I can find your ring for you. So, let's just change her ring out. So what did that get me? Increases magic by 20 points. Nah, I prefer this one. That's fine. Let's just try. Oh, look at the neckline on that thing. Oh, that's so cool. Okay, you might have to wear that at some point, Rowan. I mean, it's not very earthy because it's like, oops, totally armored up. But, oh, I love that too. Check that out. Oh, you can see nice toned arms. It's a bit colorless, but we can put the amulet on you. And oh my gosh, it looks so pretty. But I only just got you. So I'm putting you back in what you were wearing. Are you sure you can't open this door from this way? I mean, are you 100% positive? What is down here? Leather. Underground. So it requires a key. Okay, so I am gonna have to find somebody else. Sorry. No, I haven't! I'm sorry, Harbick. I'm sorry. I don't have time for I can't steal stuff. I'll get there in a minute, okay? I need to go find... Shoot, what was his name? Bol? I don't remember. I need to just find the scholar. Ooh, he might be back there. There's a dude right here. We should speak to him. Vitus.
You're on your way to speak with the Jarl.
I am, thank you. What's your story, Vitus?
Name's Castellus Vitus.
I'm sorry, Vitus.
Military engineer of the Imperial Legion.
Your voice sounds a little funny.
Out of action right now. But don't worry, I'm still in the service. What about you?
I'm loyal to... Wow, actually. What is Rowan? She'd stay out of the conflict, to be honest.
Now that's just the sort of cowardly nonsense I'd expect from a Stormcloak sympathizer.
Wow.
Off with you then. Go on. Go bother somebody else.
Come on, we're all friends down here. I just want to be friends.
Well,
thank you for Winter's persuasion
but
level.
But don't think that friendship will last if we ever get out of here.
Oh honey, you're
you
probably going to be dead when
that,
I get out of here. Because
right?
I don't know that I can save you. There are multiple endings to this storyline, I might point out. So it is highly likely that I will not find a way to save these people. Do you know a way out of here?
If I did, I'd be up there. Fighting the good fight.
That's a very good point,
Legion.
Actually.
I'm not stuck in this hole like an old bear during winter.
I'm sorry for asking. I had another question. Apparently, I had another question.
Spit it out, then.
I don't know what are my options. What have you been working on? Oh, what do you do around here? Would be
Jarl's
the
got
sensible
me working on
first
repairs
question.
To the Citadel. This
repairs?
Was
what happened to
blast,
it?
But it still needs an engineer.
Oh, lady, don't go far. I need you.
Every now and then. Door hinges need to be oiled. Cracks need to be patched up. And that bloody water pipe in the bathroom is constantly
spilling
a leak. Oh gosh,
jeez, she took one look at Roman and went in the opposite direction.
No doubt the Jarl will make good use of your skills too, whatever those might be.
My skills are in destruction magic, nature-based magic actually, nature spells. I don't think the Jarl's going to have much of a use for those. So what have you been do you understand the technology behind the Citadel? Why not?
Yes, well, not
best response
little.
Ever.
I think I understand the pipes that run all over the place. See, they mainly carry water. There's a single pipe on the top floor bringing water from outside the Citadel inside. Water then trickles down from each floor to the lake.
So gravity
but that's
takes
not
hold.
All. It seems the water flowing through these pipes causes these gears to rotate.
Yes.
And when that happens, they somehow create light.
Oh, I don't know about
the
that
dwarves
part.
Were brilliant engineers.
See, I'm
I doubt I could hold a candle to them. Not that I would need to with all the lights in this place.
Ha! You're funny! What have you been working on?
Ah yes, my workshop. Well, of course, as an engineer, through and through, I couldn't resist the urge to dismantle some of this dwarven technology. How complicated can it be, I thought. As it turns out, it's extremely complicated. You see these gleaming dwarven busts in every room?
I think I know what you mean.
Well, I think I know what they are. They all seem to be connected to the pipes running all over the city and down the front of the Citadel. And I've seen these things.
It's a Citadel Dwemer structure.
These are different. Their eyes are glowing with blue light. Have you noticed? But whenever you see one of these things, remember, someone
the Centurions.
Or something is watching everything you do, waiting for you to break the dwarves' law.
I'll be going now.
Right you are.
Okay, where did that lady go? Was she east? Oh, hi. Come back! I'd like to speak to you, lass. You're not the one I saw before, but...
Welcome,
hi! Oh, hi, Isma! What's your story, Isma?
My story?
I'm a bit close, I'm sorry.
Oh, not much to tell, love. I just work the land, make sure we've got enough food for everyone. Can't afford to run out here, you
it's
know?
Hard work.
It's true enough.
Probably harder than being Jarl. But I don't mind it. Keeps me active as I'm getting on a bit. And I sleep soundly every night.
You don't think the Jarl works hard? I don't think it does either.
No, love. I don't think he works hard at all.
So much to do.
And I'd say the same to his face if I ever saw him. But he's always hiding up there in his citadel.
Doing. Oh dear.
You know what? I'm not even sure what he does. I know he doesn't keep order. We've got the dwarves' law for that.
That's a good
but
point.
Live and let live, I say. Long as I have a roof over my head and food on my table, and good neighbors like Gulvar.
Because he lives next
I
to
can't
you.
Complain.
Yeah. Do you know a way out of here?
Oh, come on, love. It's not that bad, is it? You've only just arrived. Why not give the place a chance before you go looking for a way out?
But you would assume that everybody here would already have looked for a way out and didn't find one. I don't belong here. I need to get out.
Well, I'm sorry you feel that
I'm
way.
Sorry I have to thrust these feelings upon you.
But I'm afraid I don't know if there's a way out or not. Now that I think about it,
yes?
You might want to talk to Degland over at the Honest Trader.
Okay.
Offered to sell me a way out a while back, but his price was steep. to you.
Okay. Thank you. Oh gosh, there's a very high wall. Thanks, Ismar. Now, where was I? I can go into that building. The citadel's over there. Yes, I may as well go into this building. Oh, are you what's-his-face? Oh, here's Diglund!
Welcome to our city. I trust you've spoken with our Yao.
Not yet. What's your story?
My story?
I can afford the way out.
Well,
I've got a shit ton of money. Thanks, Winter.
And I'm a merchant, yeah? What's people say to me? Deglund, they say. Deglund, why are you a
they
merchant?
They find it surprising because I'm such an honest and trustworthy person. And sometimes you hear about your merchants who are, you know, dishonest.
Well, I say to those people, I'm not like them. My father used to say to me, Deglund, you can't be like the others. You be a good
and
boy.
And I was, my friend. I was not only just a good boy. I was the best boy. The best boy now and the best merchant with the best prices for you.
Sounds like you just want me to spend my money. But anywho, I will pay for the way out.
My friend, you're in luck. I actually do. But, let's keep
Where
it down.
Where did it come from, Deglund?
Don't want anyone else to hear, do we?
But, maybe.
I'll be honest with you, my friend. I'm looking after you. There's a bit of a catch. See, it's only going to work for one person, yeah. I've been keeping it to myself, you know, thinking maybe I'll need it myself one day. But, I'm a reasonable guy, yeah. I reckon I could be, what's the word, persuaded? Persuaded to give it away for, say, 1,000 gold coins?
I'd like more information first. Isn't there some other way I can help you? Alright, here's your money. Let's talk about something else. Rowan is a wary sort of character, so she'd like more information.
My friend, I can tell you it involves magic. Very special and very rare magic.
What kind of magic?
But, I shouldn't say
the Dwemer didn't have
that.
Magic, as far as I know.
I need to eat, you know.
She'd probably say that, but to hell with it. Take your money.
Oh, good choice, my friend.
He collapsed.
You won't regret it. Oh, and if you do, no refunds.
Great.
Not that it'll matter, because you'll be out of here in no time.
And here it is. It's called an elixir of acrobatics.
Oh, dear.
I got it from an alchemist in Morrowind years ago. And I've kept it with me just in case.
And now it's all yours.
Once you drink it, you'll be able to jump like a skeever on Skooma. You should be able to leap up to the shaft at the entrance.
Now go, my friend. Get out of here and be free.
I have a feeling I can't jump that high. Just saying. I don't think I can jump quite that high. So that's Deglund.
Ah, there she is.
Who?
Such a pretty thing.
Oh, there's lots of people over there. People. Do you know where a ring is? I'm trying to find a ring, actually. Hi, lass.
Welcome.
Oh, it's Miranda with Harbick.
What's your story with the Jarl?
What's your story? Oh, we couldn't know your story, but I'll ask anyway.
Oh, there's not much to tell.
You're really
My
pretty.
Husband, Habik, runs the clothing store in town. You should stop by. I'm sure you'll leave looking much better.
Are you dissing my armor?
No, I mean, it's just, you know, nice clothes are... Oh, who am I kidding? I'm no good at selling anything.
That's why your husband does it.
I guess that's why they've got me sweeping the floors day in, day out.
What a crap job. I'm sorry for you, Miranda.
Well, that, and we weren't invited to be layabouts in the Jarl's Citadel.
Layabouts?
Did you see anyone working in the Citadel?
I haven't been there yet.
I'll bet you didn't. They just amuse themselves all day, while those of us down here do all the work. And why? Because Habik's a Red Guard and I'm a Breton. I bet if we were both Imperial, it'd be a different story. The worst part is we left Solitude to get away from bigoted Nords after our son died. But here, the Imperials are even worse.
Okay, can I ask you something? Is there anything
of course.
I want to ask? I know what happened to his son. Nope, I'm happy to leave. See,
Welcome,
Miranda.
Newcomer.
Okay, I was still going around the back. To here. Branda's house. Is Branda's here? I'm terribly sorry to impose. Hi. Oh my. You're blind in one eye, Branda's.
You there. Come over here.
What's your story?
My... What? That doesn't matter now. I don't have much time.
Oh my god, are you dying?
I just
those bandages on your arms.
The others all think I'm mad.
What? Oh dear god. What did you want to tell me?
Stendar. He plants these images in my head. He shows me.
You're vigilant.
Secrets.
Vigilant
made
Brandis.
Me come here.
What did you see?
Something terrifying. Deep in the earth beneath the city. Powerful. And evil. I went down into the tunnels to destroy it, but the energy. It seeps into your bones. Please. Please, you must find a way to get down there. And finish what I...
Oh, dear God, he just died. Oh God, there's blood everywhere. Bloody rags. Whoa. Oh my God, he magical. I don't really need to sell anything. Although, I did spend a lot of money. I might just... Oh my God! What happened? You're like crisped. Holy crap. I don't go down there and find out what happened. Who's got a will? I, Brandis of the Vigilance of Stendar, make this will. I leave all my worldly possessions, including my immaculate dwarf boots, to whoever is willing to continue my mission to rid this place of the evil that lies buried beneath the city. May Stendar's blessing protect you. Brandis, first day of last... Oh, he just finished writing his will before he died. Poor guy. I really feel for you. Should I... Oh, it suckers into stealing. I will take it in that case. What's back there? Door of Health is apparently considered stealing. What's the difference? Are these the boots you mentioned? Immaculate Dwarven boots. The hell? They're like uber high shoes. I couldn't even think of what I wanted to say, but okay. Talk to an expert about the Immaculate Dwarven armor. Habik? Is he considered an expert on the matter? I don't rightly know. Well, we haven't gotten very far, and there's still a lot to do in this town before we head up to the Citadel. So, I might have to just leave it there, just because time is getting away, and there is just so much left to do. Oh, I'm so excited to be doing this mod. It just feels like a huge DLC on its own. Oh, can't wait to keep going. Thank you so much for watching this ep, guys, and I hope I'll see you soon for episode 2 of season 2.